Confused about the cosmos? Can't tell a planet from a star? Then give us just 5 minutes, and we'll show you what they are. Jack Horkheimer, Stargazer, tells you all about the night sky and the biggest show of all, the universe. And now, this week's episode.
How to find two wonders of summer skies, the heart of the scorpion and the heart of our galaxy. Greetings, greetings, fellow stargazers. Did you know that on any moonless night in August, you can use an ancient constellation to find two incredible summer night sky sights? Both the magnificent red heart of the scorpion and the incredible milky white heart of our galaxy. Let me show you. Okay, we've got our sky set up for this week and next, just after it gets dark out, facing south, where you will see two of summer's most famous star patterns, a constellation which looks like a fishhook or capital letter J, Scorpius the Scorpion, and directly behind it, several bright stars which, if connected by lines, would look like a teapot. Now, Scorpius is officially called a constellation, but the teapot is not. It is called an asterism, which means that it is a small pattern of stars within a constellation. And the constellation to which the teapot belongs is a very large pattern of stars named thousands of years ago for a mythical creature called a centaur, a creature half man and half horse. Named Sagittarius, he was known to be a great master with a bow and arrow, a centaur archer. His bow is marked by two stars, the teapot's lid and the star at the bottom of the spout. The arrow goes from the top star in the handle through the other star of the lid with the tip of the arrow marked by the stars, which also marks the tip of the spout. And with a little imagination, you can see that it is almost aimed at the red star, which marks the heart of the scorpion, and Ceres, which is a giant star 700 times as wide as our sun. But on really dark, moonless nights far from city lights, you'll also see that the tip of Sagittarius' arrow is embedded in the widest and densest part of that great ribbon of light called the Milky Way, which stretches all the way from the southern horizon up to the zenith and back down to the northeast horizon. In fact, if you look closely at Sagittarius and Scorpius, you will see that most of the teapot and the bottom half of Scorpius are embedded in the Milky Way. And if you take a pair of binoculars and look here or anywhere along the Milky Way, you will see that it is made up of millions of pinpoints of light, each one of which is a distant star, which along with our sun, all belong to a giant cosmic spiral family of 200 billion stars we call the Milky Way galaxy. Our galaxy is shaped kind of like putting two plates face to face together, thin around the outside with a big bulge in the center. And you'll notice that when you look at Sagittarius and Scorpius, that the Milky Way bulges here and is much thicker and wider than the rest of the Milky Way. And that's because the bulging center of our galaxy lies in this direction, over 24 light years away. In fact, the tip of Sagittarius' arrow is pointed directly at it. So, find the heart of our Milky Way galaxy and the heart of the scorpion with the help of an ancient archer. Keep looking up!
Make the Stars Your Own is available on DVD or VHS for $19.95.
Bye.